was told I was beautiful.
Piink, and welcome back to my channel again. As you can see the title, this the power of makeup trend has been going on all over YouTube, all over in the beauty community, even, you know, in regular community, if you want to call it that. It has been trending. I first saw it on, I think her name was Makeup Doll. I think I saw her do it, and then she mentioned Nikki tutorials. Then I went back to the originator and looked at her video to get an idea about what it was about, because I wanted to be sure that I knew what I thought it was about, that that's what it was about, if that makes sense. And I really liked it. I really enjoyed it. I love what it stands for, so I decided to do my own take on it. I want to say like a year or two ago, another makeup artist, and I think her name is Drini, I'll definitely put a picture somewhere up in here. She did a similar take on the not wearing makeup thing. It wasn't called the power of makeup, but it was called something else, and I joined it on that. I stand for everything that makeup is, and I stand for everything that being natural is as well. So when these little things come up, I'm all for it. So I decided to do my take on it. I'm going to do half of my face, which would be this side, in makeup, and leave this side, of course, natural, and talk a little bit about what I believe the power of makeup is to me. So definitely stay tuned. I definitely want to tell anyone that's watching to to love yourself in your natural form, your most purest form, and don't let makeup or weave or clothes or money or any of those superficial things define you. So without further ado, let's get into this video. Okay, Pink Stars, so I already moisturized my face. I'm going to take this primer from Revlon Photo Ready and put this all over the left side of my face. Next is my eyebrows. I do have a full tutorial on this. I'll link it down below. But I'm using this MAC brow pencil, and this is the color Stud. Okay, so next I'm going to go in with my concealer to clean up my brows. This is the Studio Fix Concealer, I believe, from MAC, and this is in the color NW35. This is my color, my natural color. I usually use NW25 as a highlighter color, but I'm all out, so this is going to have to do. Next, I'm taking my NYX Shadow Primer. This is in the color White. Next, I'm going to use this Wet n Wild palette. I believe the name of it is called Vanity. Using that neutral taupe color just to use it as a transition color right above my... This is a Sephora palette I won in a giveaway like a while ago, and I'm just going to use that brownish auburn color to blend out the corner of my eye, the outer corner into the inner corner, I'm sorry. Using this kind of shimmery greenish color, I'm going to put that all over my lid.
Now to darken out my outer corner, I'm going to go back into that same Sephora palette and use a little bit of black that I have left and blend that out. My camera's not really focusing, but this is a beautiful glitter shimmer type pigment from a company that no longer exists, so no, I don't need to mention it. And I'm just going to take this and put it in my inner tear duct. It's called 14 karat gold. Okay, so I was not liking how this green came out. It's not as a shimmer like I wanted it to. So I was sent some items from Yannick like a long time ago. It was like a bunch of little sample pigments, and I'm going to use this one. This is called Dignified, and I'm going to place this all over my lid. Okay, here I'm just cleaning up my eye with a wipe and putting some more primer back under there. And I am about to go in with my most favorite foundation, and that is the Maybelline Fit Me. And this one is the dewy one, and I'm 330 Toffee, one of those. Also, I forgot to mention in the beginning of this video, my eye had broke out a little bit. I'm not sure why. I had like a dry patch on it. So if you see where it seems to look like it's like caked up eyeshadow or like patches of eyeshadow, that's not what it is. I just had some little eye stuff going on. But yes, I am buffing my foundation in and blending it right on out. So I'm going to take one of my favorite almost gone LA Pro Concealers and use that for my concealing under my eyes and for my highlight. This is the color Warm Sand. This is Blunt by MAC. It is a blush, but I normally use this to lightly contour my cheeks. This is a sample of the Sasha Buttercup powder. And I must say that I'm loving it, and I will be purchasing the big one. This is my little MAC mascara that they sent me, I guess as a gift, a little sample or whatever, but I like it. I'm using this on my lashes. Now this baby right here, I'm using as my highlight. This is from a company, a local company from the DMV actually, I believe it's pronounced Rosimoto or Rosimoto or something like that. But she has a cosmetics company, and I think she sells like jewelry and hats and all that good stuff. I will link it down below, but this stuff is the truth. Oops, I forgot to mention this color is called Rosy Gold, and it's very beautiful and shimmery. I'm loving it. Last, I'm going to go in with my MAC Skin Finish in Medium Deep and just set my face all over. Here, I'm just going to go in and put on my little cute little lashes. I'm going back in with the pigment from Yannick called Dignified, and I'm going to put that under my lash line. So here I'm going to go with my Wet n Wild Volume Mascara and add it to my bottom lashes. Give it some volume. This is really good, you guys. I can't remember the name of this liquid liner. I think it's by NYC, but it's a good liquid liner, and I'm going to use this to line my lash and make a little wing at the end. So I must have had a Riri moment because I thought I was recording when I started putting this on, but I didn't. So I am now recording it. This is the new lipstick that MAC just released by Ariana Grande, and it's like a beautiful matte deep plum color. And last but not least, I'm just going to go back in with my concealer, my NW35 Studio Fix by MAC, and just clean up my lips to give it a perfect, crisp cleanup. And this helps stop lipstick from bleeding out over top of your lip line. So just when I thought I was finished, I decided that I wanted a little bit of redness in my cheek. So I'm going in with this Milani Fake Blush in Red Beano and adding that to the apples of my cheek.
Okay, PiinkStarz, so now we are done with our look, and this is the look I came up with. I don't want to ramble on too much because I can speak on this topic forever, but as you all know, makeup has become very popular, and lots of people seem to think that makeup is only to cover up something, or you're hiding behind it, or I don't know, you're trying to be somewhere you're not. I don't know where people get their logics from. I'm not sure. Maybe we need to all get together and create some makeup history books or something. I don't know, but me personally, I can't speak for everyone because everyone has their own reasons. Some people may use makeup to cover up and to hide behind all that stuff. But for me, makeup is an accessory. It enhances like you would do earrings. It enhances as you would wear a chain, have your hair done a certain way, a necklace. It's just an accessory. That's how I look at it. It's something added to enhance the beauty that's already there. I say this over and over again.
It enhances the beauty that's already there.
So, for me, I don't wear makeup because I feel as though I have to. I don't wear makeup because I just, well, I can't live without it, so I can't say that, but I wear it because I want to. Blessfully, if that's the word, but thankfully, I'll say that I don't really have blemishes on my skin. My skin is actually very nice and smooth. I never suffer with pimples. I do have a little bit of freckles, which is cool. My skin has a natural glow. So for me, it's not about covering anything. I just like it. It's so pretty. You can do all types of things with it. I do my eyebrows any kind of way I want. I can make my eye shape any kind of way I want. My lips can be, well, they're already big, but I can make them super huge. There's so many things that you can do with makeup. There is power in makeup, please believe it. But there's so many things that you can do with makeup, and it doesn't have to be that you're insecure and all this other stuff. It kills me when people put up posts, and the first thing the females that maybe should wear makeup is saying is, I'm team natural, and I have natural beauty, and I don't need to wear makeup. I really want to say you do need to wear makeup, but I don't go there. Hey, it's your own personal preference, but I don't know what it is. I don't know what it is about makeup. I don't know if they really want to wear it, and they don't know how. I don't know what it is, but I don't know. So maybe some people just need some help. I don't know. But makeup is a beautiful thing. Makeup is, it can be confidence for some. Makeup can be a booster for some. Or makeup can just have you killing the scene because that's what you want to do. Me personally, when I go out and about, I want to kill the scene. I want to slay. I want to be like a porcelain doll, and I want to walk in there like, bam, I'm here. So that's what I want to do, and that's what my makeup does for me when I want it to. On a normal basis, I am lip gloss, maybe lashes, or maybe lipstick, and nothing else. That's on a regular basis, but that's just me. If someone chooses to wear makeup every day, so what? If someone chooses to be dramatic with their makeup, so what? If someone have thick eyebrows to skinny eyebrows, you might not like it. Me personally, I don't like it either, but so what? That's them. Makeup is an art. And if you can do it, you are an artiste. And you should be happy that you have such a wonderful gift to offer yourself, and if you do other people makeup, to offer others. You can wear as much as little as you pleases. You know, you don't have to try to conform to what people around this world want you to. If that's the case, oh my god, everybody be a wreck. We will just be a mess. Yeah, a mess. So the power of makeup is really real. It can do anything. Power makeup can really transform you into look like someone else if that's what you want to do. And some people actually do look different with makeup, but the difference is if they are confident within themselves and know who they are, then who cares? Most of the time, us females that wear makeup, we have people around us who love us for us. We know who we are, and we just do it because we can, one, and because we want to. Two, I don't know if that means the same thing, but yeah, both of those. So, I don't know. I just want to say to anyone out there that's maybe having issues with how they look, or maybe wear makeup to cover up or compensate for something that they're lacking, don't use it for that. Just be you. Be your beautiful self. Be your beautiful self with acne. Be your beautiful self with blemishes. Be your beautiful self with dark spots. Because at the end of the day, when the makeup is gone, when it's just you. You have to be yourself. You have to be comfortable within your skin. Beauty shines within. So you can be the best looking person. Makeup can be on fleek and just have an ugly attitude or an ugly soul, and you're still ugly. So makeup can't cover up a person that's truly ugly within. So please remember that. Beauty shines from within. It's an attitude, it's confidence, it's your personality, it's how loving you are, how caring you are. Like, those are things that define you. Not putting on fleeky eyebrows or the newest lipstick or contouring your cheeks for the gods. My cheeks is contoured for the gods. I don't really contour, but to me this is contoured for the gods because I don't really contour. So, but anyway, back on topic. I thank you guys for watching. I really wanted to do this trend because it sticks out to me. Like, I'm often seeing different things about, if you get a girlfriend, she wear makeup, you better take her on swimming on the first day. Like, it's just tiring. And for the guys that always have something to say about wearing makeup, they don't really count because makeup is not for them in the first place. So I don't really understand why they have anything to say about it, because they don't have to wear it. So I just really think they should just be quiet and just maybe have a couple seats, maybe several. I don't know, but just sit down because it's not for you in the first place, okay? So if you want to be fly, if you want to slay, if you want to play in makeup just to, you know, to grow your skills, do you. Don't let anyone else do you for you, if that makes sense. Don't let makeup define you. Don't let social media likes define you. Don't let expensive clothes define you. Don't let others define you for you, because guess what? If you let others define you for you, you'll spend the rest of your life trying to please people who are never going to be pleased. People are going to always have something to say. I don't care if you're the most unattractive person, the most beautiful person, the richest person, the poorest person. I don't care what you are. Someone is going to have something to say. So if you're going to give them something to talk about, let it just be a nice, sweet beat. Okay, so yes, thank you guys for watching. I enjoyed doing this. I definitely encourage some of my other YouTube sisters to do this. It was fun. It's actually interesting because I never did this before. Like, it's either was no makeup or makeup. So to see half of my face without, and to see my other half with, it's cool. I got this on my head, y'all, because it's not falling how I wanted to, but whatever. Thank you guys for watching. Comment down below. Thumbs up the video. Thumbs down the video if you don't like it. Whatever. Guess what? Do you. Boo boo. Mwah. Bye, girls. Bye.